Joining me now, the president's top economic advisor at the White House, Larry Kudlow. Sir, good to see you as always. So many of us have been making this point for months. As you know, you can't reopen the economy without the virus contained. You, President Trump, others at the White House pushed for the economy to reopen. We did, and now cases have skyrocketed and the economy appears to be taking yet another hit. Isn't it clear that the country reopened too quickly, wiping away the progress that had been made, prolonging harm to the economy?
Well, Jake, I don't know. I mean, there's a lot of generalizations there. First of all, I don't think the economy is going south. I think it's going north. And I think that there's a bunch of indicators. Let me focus on that. I know something about that. You're in a housing boom right now. You're in a retail sales boom right now. You're in an auto car boom right now. Manufacturing, look at the ISM indexes, all are booming. New business applications are skyrocketing. Apple Mobility Index is very strong. And the jobs picture remains strong. There was a number of unemployment claims last week that slipped, but it was a seasonal adjustment problem. It's actually the lowest since early March. Continuing claims, which is going to predict the July jobs number out in a week or so, are the lowest they've been in almost 3 months. So I don't buy it. Now, I will acknowledge that in some of these spiking hot spots, yes, absolutely, you're going to see a moderation of this recovery. No question. On the other hand, Jake, but apart from Texas, Arizona, and Florida, and California, where, by the way, Deborah Birx says there's some signs of stabilization. The whole Northeast is over. But most of the Midwest
from,
is. I mean, the whole Northeast
three of
is
our
open.
Biggest
most
states.
Of the Midwest, Jake. Well, okay,
apart
but,
Florida,
you know, you've
Texas,
got the
California,
entire Northeast
a,
section.
Some pretty big states.
You've got. They are big states. And I don't deny that there's going to be some impact. I don't think it's a huge impact. I mean, what we're seeing in the data so far is that in those areas, yes, those big four states, not so much, by the way,
let me ask you about
Arizona,
that data.
Not so much Texas. But let me go.
What, let me ask you about that data, because I want to say the Census Bureau.
Where there are let me just one
census,
second. I won't be long.
Let me just ask you about this because you want to talk about the data. The Census Bureau's new weekly survey. The Census Bureau's new weekly survey during the pandemic suggests job numbers have taken a turn for the worse. Our viewers can see. Let's put up the graphic in question five. Our viewers can see total unemployment is actually going down, suggesting the U.S. may have lost almost seven million jobs rather in the last month. Is it possible that the employment picture in the U.S.
Total.
Will look worse in July than it did in June? Is that possible, do you think?
No. No, I don't believe so. I can't see your numbers, Jake. I'm sorry, sitting in this truck. But I will say this. You said total unemployment is going down. That is correct. The continuing claims, which lead unemployment,
total employment
is
falling
rapidly.
Total employment is going down.
Well,
total employment is going down.
I don't know.
If
the
I misspoke,
Census
I
Bureau,
apologize.
You know, most, I forgive you, it's okay. Most people look at the Bureau of Labor Statistics that print out the weekly claims and the monthly jobs numbers. All right, that's what I haven't seen those census numbers, and I don't know that I'd put a lot of stock in it, but whatever. The fact it remains, as I was saying before, in some places, job declines or job increases have been affected. I don't deny it, but it's being made up by people calling back employees so that actually the joblessness rate is going to fall. I'm not going to suggest, I don't know the July number. We'll all learn it in about a week or so. But I do think the odds favor a big increase in job creation and a big reduction in unemployment. I just want to make the point, though, all these other signals, Jake, most economists, Wall Street, elsewhere, are suggesting we are in a self-sustaining recovery. Now, you can argue about the speed of it. I get that. And you can, and I don't deny that some of these hotspot states are going to moderate that recovery. But on the whole, the picture is very positive. And I still think the V-shaped recovery is in place. And I still think, Jake, there's going to be 20% growth rate in the third and fourth quarters.
I guess the point is that the places in the world that didn't open up too early, their economies are bouncing back better than ours is right now, because by all data and analysis, many parts of the country opened too quickly and without enough mitigating factors. But let's talk about the negotiations on Capitol Hill right now for a new stimulus package.
How about the
Republicans want to
just one point on the
yeah go
just one point I I can't, you know, you may be right in some places, you may not be right, Jake. I don't think that's proven, but we don't need to prove it. It is what it is. I just want to say, for those people like myself and the president who do want reopening everywhere and job creation everywhere and a strong recovery, the four guidelines have to remain in place. Masking,
everybody wants that, though. Everybody testing. Wants all of that. They just want it safely.
Well, yes, safely is important. And again, jobs and kids are the themes of the recovery package that's coming up in the next week or two. And those four
guidelines. So let's talk about that. I want
to
talk about the recovery package.
I just want to say it publicly. So, okay.
Yeah, Republicans want to end the $600 per week in additional unemployment. They want to replace it with 70% of previous wages. That loss of income for millions of Americans could lead to evictions. It could lead to people not being able to pay for food or medicine or electricity. Are you concerned that changing this, the way that this unemployment compensation is given, that stopping this funding will actually end up causing further damage to the economy with people not able to pay their bills, with people being evicted?
Jake, it won't stop. It won't stop the assistance. It's gonna cap the assistance at a level that is consistent with people going back to work. That's what we've said from day one. First of all, state unemployment benefits stay in place. Second of all, we will try to cap the benefits at about 70% of wages. You know, a University of Chicago study showed virtually 70%, 68% of people actually have higher benefits than wages. We have had a flood of inquiries and phone calls and complaints that small stores and businesses, restaurants can't hire people back. They went too far. Maybe last March it was necessary for that, but really the consequences of people not returning to work, Secretary Mnuchin said it right, we want to pay folks to go back to work. And incidentally, we are going to have, on top of the cap of wages, 70%, which is quite generous by any standard, on top of that, we will have a reemployment bonus mm-hmm. and a retention tax credit bonus for going back to work. So that's going to more than offset any of this. I mean, the trick here is going back to work. We don't want people out. We want them in wherever possible. The businesses are calling them back. That's why I'm optimistic on the economy. So far, I could be wrong, Jake, Lord knows, but so far, this, you know, the iteration here, the dynamic here is very positive.
People want to go back to work. The problem is that it's, in many cases, you talk about restaurants, it's not safe for them to go back to work because the administration and states have not been able to get the virus under control. I mean, that's the reason, that's the problem why restaurants can't hire workers. It's not because waiters and servers and maitre d's and bartenders don't want to go back to work. It's because either they're not allowed to open their bars or have significant seating in their restaurants, or it's not safe to go there. That's the whole problem. That's going to be the problem with schools in the fall. It's the problem with people reluctant to get on airplanes. I mean, it's because you were not able to get the virus under control, that the economy continues to struggle.
I will say again, the economy is improving by leaps and bounds. I will also say there are more states that are reopening and doing very well. There are some key states, yes, California and Texas and Florida right now, that are having hotspot difficulties, but it's nothing like it was last winter. I don't agree with your premise that people won't go back to work. I think safety matters. Let me make that very clear. And the four guidelines, right? The masking and the distancing particularly. Okay, you're right. But I will say this, it's a more optimistic picture than the one you are painting. And I think that we've made great strides. I mean, federal government doesn't control this. We are leaders, hopefully, in encouraging people to be safe and secure and accept our guidelines. The states are in charge of this. Each state has a different story. Most of the states are doing rather well in this. So I'm not that pessimistic. Maybe I'm too optimistic. I'm happy to report Ambassador Deborah Birx, who is our leader on the health virus task force, she's reporting now that these bad hotspot states, the three or four of them, are actually showing early signs of plateauing. Let us hope and pray that that is the case. We are doing everything we can.
We've had 4 days of more than 1,000 deaths. Yeah, I mean,
yes, the fatality rate is.
I always hope any death is a tragedy.
Any death is a tragedy, Jake. I agree. But it is also true. It is also true that the fatality rate is much slower than it was. Don't forget, in the package,
because thank God, doctors and nurses and health professionals. The doctors and nurses and health professionals are figuring out good ways to treat the virus. A lot of the people who are infected now are younger, and so it's not as high a mortality rate.
But let me just say, sir,
you paint a very rosy picture of what it looks like, what the virus looks like.
I just want to add, Jake, we're talking about employment benefits and so forth. Don't forget, there's a $1,200 check coming. That is going to be part of the new package. I would have preferred a payroll tax cut on top of that check, but be that as it may, politically it doesn't work. But the check is there. The reemployment bonus is there. The retention bonus is there. There'll be breaks for small tax credits for small businesses and restaurants. That's all going to be there.